Why is marijuana not legal? Why is marijuana not legal? It's a natural plant that grows in the dirt. You know what's not natural? 80-year-old dudes with hard-ons. That's not natural, but we got pills for that. We're dedicating all our medical resources to keeping the old guys erect, but we're putting people in jail for smoking something that grows in the dirt. You know, we have more prescription drugs now. Every commercial on TV is a prescription drug ad. I can't watch TV for 4 minutes without thinking I have 5 serious diseases. Like, do you ever wake up tired in the mornings? Oh my God, I have this. Write this down. Whatever it is, I have it. Half the time, you don't even know what the commercial is. There's people running through fields or flying kites or swimming in the ocean. Like, that is the greatest disease ever. How do you get that? That disease comes with a hot chick and a puppy. The schools, now it's all about self-esteem in the schools. Build the kids' self-esteem, make them feel good about themselves. If everybody grows up with high self-esteem, who's gonna dance in our strip clubs? What's gonna happen to our porno industry? These women don't just grow on trees. It takes lots of drunk daddies missing a lot of dance recitals before you decide to blow a goat on the internet for $50. And if that disappears, where does that leave me on a Friday with my new high-speed connection? Comes up all the time. You keep hearing about these terrorist masterminds that are being killed over in the Middle East. Terrorist masterminds. Masterminds, sort of a lofty way to describe what these guys do, don't you think? They're not masterminds.
Okay, you take bomb, right? And you put in backpack, then you get on the bus and you blow yourself up.
Why do I have to blow myself up? Why don't I put...
Who's the f***ing mastermind here, me or you?
Americans, let's face it, we've been a spoiled country for a long time. You know what the number one health risk in America is? Obesity. Obesity. They say we're in the middle of an obesity epidemic. An epidemic like it's polio, like we'll be telling our grandkids about it one day. The great obesity epidemic of 2004. How'd you get through it, Grandpa?
Oh, it was horrible, Johnny. There was cheesecake and pork chops everywhere.
Nobody knows why we're getting fatter. Look at our lifestyles. I'll sit at a drive-thru. I'll sit there behind 15 other cars instead of getting up and making an 8-foot walk to the totally empty counter. Everything's mega meal, super size. Want biggie fries with that? Want a jumbo fry? Want to go large? Want a biggie fry? Want a 30 burgers for a nickel? You fat motherfucker, there's room in the bag. Take it. Want a 55-gallon drum of Coke with that? It's only 3 more cents. Sometimes you gotta suffer a little in your youth to motivate you to succeed later in life. You think if Bill Gates got laid in high school, you'd think there'd be a Microsoft? Of course not. You gotta spend a lot of time stuffed in your own locker with your underwear wedged up your ass before you start thinking, I'm gonna take over the world with computers, you'll see, I'll show them. We're in one of the richest countries in the world, and the minimum wage is lower now than it was 35 years ago. There are homeless people everywhere. This homeless guy asked me for money the other day. I was about to give it to him, and I thought he's just gonna use it on drugs or alcohol. And then I thought, that's what I'm gonna use it on. Why am I judging this poor bastard? People love to judge homeless guys. Like, you give him the money, he's just gonna waste it. He's gonna waste the money. Well, he lives in a box. What do you want him to do with it? Save it up and buy a wall unit? Take a little run to the store for a throw rug and a CD rack? He's homeless. I walked behind this guy the other day. A homeless guy asked him for money. He looks right at the homeless guy. He goes, why don't you go out and get a job, you bum? People always say that to homeless guys. Get a job, like it's always that easy. This homeless guy was wearing his underwear outside his pants. I'm guessing his resume ain't all up to date. I'm predicting some problems during the interview process. I'm pretty sure even McDonald's has an underwear go inside the pants policy. Not that they enforce it very strictly, but technically, I'm sure it's on the books.